Hello friends, welcome to ISRSI, and today's topic is about glycolysis and the reaction mechanisms involved in glycolysis. And let us see the steps involved in glycolysis at first. In the step 1, glucose is converted to the glucose 6 phosphate by the help of an enzyme hexokinase by utilization of ATP. The ATP is converted to adenosine diphosphate by the release of a phosphate molecule. And this phosphate molecule is given to the glucose to form glucose 6 phosphate. And in the step 2 of glycolysis, by the help of phosphoglucoisomerase enzyme, the glucose 6 phosphate molecule is now converted into fructose 6 phosphate. And coming to the step 3 of glycolysis, the fructose 6 phosphate molecule is converted into fructose 1,6 bisphosphate molecule, and here again ATP is converted into ADP and inorganic phosphate, and this inorganic phosphate is given to the fructose 6 phosphate molecule to make it as fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. In the step 4 of glycolysis, fructose 1,6 bisphosphate is now converted into dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate by the help of enzyme aldolase. In the step 5, dihydroxyacetone phosphate is again converted into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate by the help of enzyme triose phosphate isomerase. And until here, 2 ATP were utilized, that is called expenditure phase. And from now on, the payoff phase starts where from the reaction of 6 to 10, 4 ATPs were produced. In the step 6 of glycolysis, glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate molecule is converted into 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate by the help of enzyme glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate dehydrogenase. And here, NAD is converted into NADH. And the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, by the help of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme, it is converted into 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate. And in the step 7, by the conversion of ADP into ATP by the help of enzyme phosphoglycerokinase, it is also called as substrate level phosphorylation, the 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate is now converted into 3 phosphoglycerate. And in the step 8, by the help of the enzyme phosphoglyceromutase, the 3 phosphoglycerate is now converted into 2 phosphoglycerate. In the step 9 of glycolysis, 2 phosphoglycerate is now converted into phosphoenolpyruvate by the help of enzyme enolase. And in the presence of magnesium plus 2 ions, the water molecule is released. And the phosphoenolpyruvate now formed in the step 10, the phosphoenolpyruvate is converted into pyruvate, and here again ADP is converted into ATP by substrate level phosphorylation by the help of enzyme pyruvate kinase. And now the pyruvate is released from the glucose by the process of glycolysis by the utilization of various enzymes. And here it is an important note that in step 10 and 7, we have 2 ATPs were released by ADP converting into the ATP. And it is to be noted that from step 4, as I said, we get dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate molecules. And at the step 5, the dihydroxyacetone is converted into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, that is, from step 5 to 10, we have the process goes with 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate giving 4 molecules of ATP at payoff phase. Now, let us see the mechanisms involved in all the reactions of glycolysis. Coming to the reaction mechanism of glycolysis, in the first step, glucose is converted into glucose 6 phosphate. And I am giving the numbering. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And the sixth carbon, CH2OH, a phosphate molecule is added. And ATP is converted into ADP. And the phosphate molecule released here is attached here by the help of enzyme hexokinase. It is specifically for hexoses and kinase in the sense it adds only the phosphate molecules. And coming to the reaction mechanism, here is the hexokinase enzyme. It is like a claw of a cat that can hold a rat firmly. That is, it has an active catalytic center that exactly fits the molecule, and the CH2OH group is exposed to ATP. And the magnesium plus 2 ions shields the negative charges of triphosphate of adenosine, and at CH2OH, the lone pair of electrons attack at the phosphate molecule, and the bond here between P and O is cleaved, and electron transfers to O, releasing a free phosphate, and this free phosphate attached here to form glucose 6 phosphate. Now, the glucose 6 phosphate molecule is converted into fructose 6 phosphate by the help of enzyme phosphoglucoisomerase, PGI. The isomerase term itself says the glucose 6 phosphate is isomerized to fructose 6 phosphate. And see here, this red color indication 1 is here, this one. So let us see how this is converted into fructose 6 phosphate by the reaction mechanism. So here, the glucose 6 phosphate molecule at the enzymatic catalytic site, and the ring opening takes place by the OH here, H, O and H, a bond from OH attacks here. And when the bond attacks here, this bond will be shifted towards H over the enzyme, hydrogen over the enzyme. And this bond will go to the hydrogen as an electron by giving H plus ions. And when this bond will go to the H plus ion, now the ring will be opened. So when the ring is opened, the lone pair present at the B will attack here. So when the lone pair at the B attacks here at the H plus, and this H plus will attack this bond, and these double bonds that are formed earlier by the attacking of this bond here, this double bond, a bond will be shifted to oxygen here. And coming to the step 3, as this one attacked here at this side, we will get double bond here. So for the stabilization purpose, as this one is given the lone pair to H plus, there will be a plus charge here. So to stabilize the plus charge, this bond will go to the H plus here. And now the exchange of H plus in the medium takes place, and cis indiol intermediate is formed. Now here the lone pair at B is donated to the H here. Now, so to the stabilization of bond, this O will be joined here, and this double bond will be shifted to this O. So when this happens, the ring closure takes place, as this O when it attacks here, and that this bond is shifted to the O by the release of H plus ions, the ring closure takes place, giving the molecule at C H, OH and H plus. And finally, fructose 6 phosphate is formed. Now, the fructose 6 phosphate is again converted into fructose 1,6 bisphosphate, that is 1 and 6 phosphate molecules here, 1 and 6 bisphosphate. By the utilization of ATP, ATP is converted into ADP and H plus ions by the help of enzyme phosphofructokinase in the presence of magnesium plus 2 ions. This reaction is almost similar to the hexokinase reaction at glucose to glucose 6 phosphate. Now, fructose 1,6 bisphosphate in the presence of enzyme aldolase is converted into dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. Let us see how. Fructose 1,6 bisphosphate, this is the fructose molecule at position 1 and position 6. And at position 1 and at position 6, see here at 1, 2, and 3, the red color molecule is the dihydroxyacetone phosphate and the remaining is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. Let us see how this happens by the reaction mechanism. So this is the reaction mechanism of dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate forming from fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. The free enzyme contains aspartic acid at 33 and lysine 220. This is the free enzyme. And when the fructose 1,6 bisphosphate enters the enzyme catalytic site, the double bond here, a bond from the C double bond O, a bond from C enters to the O and giving the O negative charge. Now the NH2 plus attacks here, and finally the enzyme substrate complex takes place. Here, protonated skip phase formation takes place by the release of water molecule. CH2C double bond O molecule, that is aspartate molecule. A electron from O is donated to H here, and this bond shifts here. And when this bond shifts here, this bond will be given to carbon, second carbon. And see here, already there are double bonds here. So for the stabilization purpose, a bond from here is given to NH plus. Now, when this bond is given here and this bond is given here, we get C double bond O. And when this bond is taken here, there will be cleavage of the molecule takes place, releasing glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. This is called aldol cleavage. And formation of enamine intermediate. So see here, this electron from O attacked at H here. So this one is joined with this blue color thing. I am explaining this one. This one is joined with this blue color thing. From here onwards, now the lone pair of electrons attacks at this bond at carbon. And when lone pair of electrons attacks at this bond at carbon, this bond is shifted to here and this one is shifted to here. So when this one is shifted to here, the connection between these two is broken. Now the H will be remaining here. This is the enzyme product, protonated skip base. And finally, by the release of water, dihydroxyacetone product is formed. In this step of glycolysis, glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is converted into 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate. So here, this is the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, where at the third carbon there is a phosphate molecule, and here at position 1 there is a phosphate molecule is added, that is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is converted into 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate. C double bond OH, remember this, and I will explain the reaction mechanism involved in this reaction. Coming to the reaction mechanism here, this is a free enzyme by the addition of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate molecule. This is the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate molecule. This is the aldehyde group, where a bond from C double bond O attacks at O, forming negative charge at the O. So when this bond attacks at O, there will be a plus at the C, which is satisfied from this bond
here. That is, a lone pair from B, a lone pair gets attacked here, releasing this bond to be joined here, making a connection between these two. So when this attacks here, a negative charge is formed, and when this lone pair gets attacks here, there will be a plus at the B, forming thiohemiacetal intermediate. And the next step, the minus here, the O, attacks here, forming double bond. And this double bond is reflected here. And due to the stabilization purpose, this bond, that is this H, will be going to NAD plus, satisfying NAD plus for the formation of NADH. And when this attacks here, there will be a formation of double bond, making C double bond O, acyl thioester intermediate. And now, in the presence of NADH, NADH is converted into NAD plus and a phosphate. And this phosphate enters into the enzyme, attacking at this thing, forming 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Now, at this position, an excess electron or the negative charge or the electron over the O attacks at the carbon, making this bond to be attacked at the hydrogen and making this bond getting satisfied by attacking at B plus ions that has deficient of electrons. Now, when this bond attacks H, the cleavage takes place, releasing the C double bond O R and PO3 minus 2. Here, this is the phosphate molecule attacks here. When this phosphate molecule attacks here, the formation of phosphate bond takes place, releasing the free enzyme, releasing 3-phosphate molecule.
Now, coming to the formation of 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate to 3-phosphoglycerate by the help of enzyme phosphoglycerokinase. So here, this is the 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. The phosphate molecule is given in red color. By the help of magnesium plus 2 ions and by the help of phosphoglycerokinase, there will be formation of 3-phosphoglycerate. And this ADP is added with the phosphate molecule of this one. This phosphate molecule is added to the ADP to form ATP. Let's see the mechanism. 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, and the magnesium plus 2 ions in the phosphoglycerokinase shields the negative charges at O minus in adenosine triphosphate. Now, the minus charge at O, that is an electron from O, attacks the phosphate molecule at 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Now, a negative charge from O or an electron from O attacks at the P site or P, giving this bond to be shifted to O, giving O minus and 3-phosphoglycerate. And when this bond shifts to here, this phosphate is released from this molecule, making adenosine triphosphate. That is, when this one attacks here, this bond attacks here. So when this one attacks here, this phosphate is attached to adenosine diphosphate and forming ATP by giving 3-phosphoglycerate. In this reaction, 3-phosphoglycerate is converted into 2-phosphoglycerate. That is, 3-phosphoglycerate by the help of enzyme phosphoglycero-mutase is converted into 2-phosphoglycerate. Here, the phosphate at third carbon is shifted to second carbon. Let us see the mechanism. Here in the step one, it is an empty enzyme or free enzyme. By the addition of 3-phosphoglycerate to this enzyme, the phosphate molecule at third carbon, this enzyme has histidine attached with a phosphate molecule. And in the step two of this mechanism, this phosphate is transferred to second carbon of 3-phosphoglycerate at OH position, giving 2-3 bisphosphoglycerate, and in the final step, the phosphate at third carbon is given to the enzyme here by reforming the enzyme and finally releasing the 2-phosphoglycerate, forming 2-phosphoglycerate from 3-phosphoglycerate. This reaction involves the 2-phosphoglycerate is formed into phosphoenol pyruvate by the help of enzyme enolase. See here, 1, 2 and 3, 3 carbons, 2-phosphoglycerate means at the second position there is a phosphate molecule. The red color H here and OH here. See here, in the phosphoenol pyruvate there is no OH and there is no H, but there is a double bond at C with a H2O molecule. Let us see how this happens. So here, this is a free enzyme, and this enzyme has NH2 lysine 345 and NH3 plus lysine 396 and glutamic acid at 211. And when the molecule enters in this enzyme, or substrate enters here, the lone pair at here NH2, an electron is transferred to H of here. When the electron is transferred to H of here, a bond from here shifted to here, and a double bond from here is shifted to O. So in the next step, when a bond shifted to here, it will form a double bond. See here the double bond. When the lone pair is given to H, there will be a plus charge here. And when this bond is shifted to here, there will be negative charge at the O. Now, the negative charge at the O, or the excess electron at the O, an electron is donated to this bond. So when an electron is donated to this bond, the double bond here will be shifted to this bond at this carbon. Now, when the double bond at this carbon is shifted to this bond at this carbon, the bond holding the C and OH here will be shifted to H here, and this bond from H and O will be shifted to here, O. And the step 2 is rather slow, forming this intermediate phosphoenol pyruvate. That is, when this one is shifted to here, OH, and this one is shifted to at O, giving negative charge to the O, and this OH and H joins to form water by the release of water. And in the case of rapid exchange, when this bond, means the negative charge at O, attaches here, the double bond will be shifted to here, and this one, this bond attacks at H and this bond attacks at O. By the rapid exchange of H2O, a OH bond is formed here, and the magnesium plus 2 ions holds the substrate in its catalytic position, and finally the phosphoenol pyruvate is formed. Now this reaction is the final conversion of phosphoenol pyruvate to pyruvate. This is the phosphoenol pyruvate in presence of ADP. ATP is formed by the release of pyruvate by the help of enzyme pyruvate kinase. So let us see the reaction mechanism. Phosphoenol pyruvate in the sidewise, horizontal wise, and in presence of magnesium, the magnesium shields the negative charges at O, and the potassium ion also holds the entire molecule in its catalytic site. Adenosine diphosphate in presence of adenosine diphosphate. A phosphate at this O is cleaved to give ATP. That is, adenosine diphosphate here, the two O presented, the two phosphates of adenosine is shielded by magnesium plus 2. So they don't interact in the reaction, but a O here having electron or the excess electron or the negative charge attacks at the P here, and this O P bond, the bond here will be attacking at the position of O, giving negative charge to the O. And when this one attacks here, this phosphate and this adenosine diphosphate is joined to form adenosine triphosphate, and here we will get a O minus here, enol pyruvate, and in presence of H plus ions, the double bond at C double bond CH2, a bond from here is shifted to CH2, and the minus charge at O will be given to here, forming double bond, and final formation of the product pyruvate.